Flying cars have been on the technological landscape for generations, but just like a lot of ideas, these things don't always turn out as planned. This is Reacher, and we're catching up on where a few of them are today, as well as where they might have drawn their inspiration.
Number 10.
In the late 1980s, aeronautics company Sky Innovations sunk $6 million into the design and production of a flying car. Named the Sky Commuter, it features a forward-raising bubble canopy covering the two-seater cabin. The controls consisted of a center-mounted joystick and foot pedals on both sides, allowing for the craft to be controlled from either seat. Designed for a vertical takeoff and landing, the Commuter is equipped with three large lifting fans as well as having jet propulsion for forward thrust. A non-functioning prototype is all that remains, having gone on the auction block in 2015 with a starting price of $71,500.
Number 9.
This two-seat folding wing vehicle looks more like an actual aircraft than it does a car. The Transition has a top speed around 100 miles per hour in flight mode with a range of 400 miles. Converting from flight to driving mode can be done in under a minute, allowing it to be stored in a standard single car garage. The company also has the next generation in the concept stages, an integrated transport system called TF2. The three-part system has a main cabin that is mounted on a road vehicle that can then be seamlessly offloaded to an air vehicle. Terrafugia is finalizing production in preparation for a 2019 delivery date, but has yet to release any information on pricing.
Number 8.
A car that flies, a plane that drives. That's exactly how the manufacturers of the PAL V Liberty described their vehicle. And that's enough for me to say, shut up and take my money. Developed by Dutch engineers and an Italian design team, the two-seater measures just over 13 feet long, 6.5 feet wide, and 5.5 feet high in drive mode. The 100 horsepower engine can produce a top speed of 100 miles per hour with an estimated range of 800 miles. When in flight mode, the length and height increase to 20 feet and 10.5 feet, respectively, with the rotor having a diameter just over 35 feet. The top speed increases to 112 miles per hour with a flight range of 248 miles. If you're interested, the company also offers a fly drive academy, providing the necessary training to operate the vehicle. The PAL V currently comes in two models, ranging in price from $400,000 to $600,000.
Number 7.
This next entry is called the Trixy TrixFormer. It consists of an electric motorcycle with an attachable flying component that allows it to operate as an autogyro. The fuselage of the aircraft, which is formed from composites and a framework of metal tubing, has an open cockpit with a two-seat tandem setup. It gets its power from a four-cylinder 130 horsepower engine that can reach a top speed of 112 miles per hour. The main rotor measures just over 28 feet in diameter, while the whole thing has a dry weight of 772 pounds. The company also has a second design in the works called the V2 that offers a sleeker design with a fully enclosed cockpit. This version will have multiple docking capabilities, allowing it to function as a boat, plane, or helicopter as well. Before you strap yourself into one of these machines, be sure and update your life insurance policy. And while you're at it, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and click that bell icon to stay up to date on all of our latest videos.
Number 6.
The carbon composite teardrop-shaped exterior of this one features a glass cockpit which mimics that of a traditional aircraft. It measures 19 feet in length with retractable wings that open up to a span of just under 29 feet. Powered by a hybrid electric propulsion system, the two-seater can reach a top speed of 100 miles per hour on the road, while the four-cylinder combustion engine can achieve 224 miles per hour when in flight. The adjustable controls and digital displays are set up to integrate seamlessly from drive to flight mode upon takeoff. AeroMobil also has a 5.0 version on the drawing board, which will offer twice the seating capacity and the ability to perform as a VTOL aircraft. Along with this, it will feature a design overhaul, providing a more futuristic look to both the interior and exterior. The 4.0 is currently available for pre-order, with deliveries expected to start in 2020. The prices are a modest $1.2 to $1.6 million.
Number 5.
The Portsmouth Aerocar was a British light utility aircraft design built in the late 1940s. Intended to be an aircraft used for a variety of tasks, including being a portable office, the cabin could hold 5 passengers in addition to the pilot. The prototype had a composite construction consisting of a metal fuselage with fabric-covered wings and tail booms, while the production model was intended to be fully metal. 4 models were planned, with only one seeing the light of day and being used in a test flight by the designer. It was presented at the Society of Aircraft Constructors exhibition, but funding for the development of the craft fell through and the project was scrapped in 1950 after the production of the single prototype.
Number 4.
The Taylor Aerocar was designed and built by Moulton Taylor, drawing inspiration from the design of the Airphibian. The craft had a length of 21.5 feet with a wingspan of 34 feet and a seating capacity for 2 people. It included folding wings, which allowed it to go from flight to road ready in 5 minutes with a propeller that could attach by lifting the license plate up. The original was intended to have a 3-speed manual transmission, which could reach speeds around 60 miles per hour on the road and 115 miles per hour in the air, with a range of 300 miles. When on the road, the wings and tail were intended to be towed behind the vehicle. The company planned an initial run of 500 units, but only received orders for about half of that. Production was canceled, and over the years, only 6 examples of Taylor's vehicle have ever been built. There are also plans to build an Aerocar 2000, which is based on a Lotus Elise Roadster. A few of the original examples have gone up for auction, with prices starting as high as $2.2 million.
Number 3.
The Wagner Aerocar was developed during an era of space-age futurism, looking like something straight out of the Jetsons. It came equipped with a large 2-seat bubble cockpit, dual tail fins, and wheels that seemed too small for a car. It drew inspiration from the Rotocar 3 design, with a prototype being completed and flown in 1965. The company was bought out and development was eventually suspended in 1971.
Number 2.
The 2 prototypes of this one that were built were made by fusing the rear portion of a Cessna Skymaster to a Ford Pinto, giving it the nickname the Flying Pinto. The craft had a wingspan of 38 feet, a length of 28 feet, and a height of 8.5 feet. Production was slated to begin in 1974, with prices starting at just over $18,000. Unfortunately, a known problem with the right wing strut detaching happened during a test flight in 1973, causing a crash that killed the designer and vice president of the company, effectively ending the project. Personally, I drive like I'm flying anyway, so I probably don't need one of these aircraft at my disposal. Would you or should you give one a try? Let us know in the comments after the video. Before we reveal our number one pick, we wanted to give a nod to a few others that almost made it. First up is the Fulton FA-2 Airphibian. Manufactured in 1946, this one converted from aircraft to road vehicle by disengaging from the wing and fuselage. Only 4 were ever built before financial problems forced the creator to sell the design. Next is the SkyRider X2R from Macro Industries. First mentioned in 2000, the company estimates a cost up to $1 million each for its yet-to-be-produced prototypes. Finally, we have the Waterman Aerobile. First built in 1932, Studebaker showed interest in this one, but only 5 were built before production ceased in 1938.
Number 1.
2 prototypes of the Convair car were built, the 116 and the 118. Developed after World War II, they were intended to take advantage of the post-war aviation boom. The Model 116 consisted of a 2-seat car body with detachable wings and tail boom. It made its first flight in 1946, going on to eventually complete 66 test flights. This inspired the creator to build the Model 118, which had a refined body and more powerful flight engine. During a test flight in 1947, a crash destroyed the first prototype. The second prototype achieved flight in 1948, but by then a lack of interest caused the company to cancel the project. Next time you want to remember the good old days, just remember that the initial estimated selling price on this one was only $1,500.
Hey guys, this is Cassie. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Tell us in the comments below what you found to be the most interesting and why. Also, if you haven't done so yet, make sure to hit the bell notification next to the subscribe button to stay up to date with all of our latest videos. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time.